Hi, and thanks for joining this session. So we just decided that we will talk to a few people who are the member of School Synergy Teachers Forum instead of having a session today where there is a talk. See, in talks, we get to hear from the speaker, but we do not get to hear that much from the teachers and what is motivating them to attend these sessions, what is motivating them to join the School Synergy Teachers Forum. And we want to really know more about your motivation. Also, in what ways these sessions are meaningful to you, how we can improve it, how we can make the engagement more relevant for teachers so that they are able to incorporate these ideas more meaningfully in the practice itself. So I think it's going to be a very small group. If you all want, you can start your video. It would be nice to see faces of people who are motivated to come to this session and talk to us. What happens is when the people are giving talks and you are just supposed to listen, many people join. But when you are expected to speak and give your opinions at that point, there are not many people who are interested in joining a session, which is about discussion itself, which is a bit of a sad state because we really want to have more discussions with the teachers. And it seems right now the teachers are not ready. Also could be because we circulated the information very late and many teachers perhaps were not free at this time. I don't know. So anyway, those who are here, I am really looking forward to hearing from all of you. Dimbeshwar Sarma, sir, you have been a regular attendant for many of our School Synergy Teachers Forum, eagerly waiting for us to announce the sessions, and we have noted that. So we really want to hear from you as a teacher, like what motivates you to come to this session, what you are expecting, and how we can make these sessions more meaningful for you. So if you don't mind, you can speak. If you can open your video, it is fine. If not, then also it is okay. Yeah, please go ahead.
Okay, madam. Actually, my name is Dimbeshwar Sarma. I am from Assam in Nalbari district. I am a vocational teacher by profession at Government 10 Plus 2 School. And I have attended this School Synergy workshop at least this could be my 8th attempt, most probably. 7 okay. I have already attended.
Okay.
And I like all the sessions. So many new things I have learned, mm-hmm. especially how to engage a large number of students in a classroom. Apart from the academic activities, how we can go further to interact and make a relation with the students with some non-academic activities, which actually leads to academic activities later on. So mm-hmm. these are my learnings actually, and I am expecting more in a dynamic way, more new activities in terms of teacher education, in terms of teacher and student engagement and relationship.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thanks a lot for sharing that. In what way can we make the session more meaningful so that more teachers from your area, from the teachers you know, they will be motivated to join these sessions and interact with the faculty, interact with the ideas?
Yes, madam. Actually, I have also informed my staff, my present school staff, along with the nearby school staff also. Mm-hmm. 2 to 3 teachers have already joined previous one or two School Synergy workshop. Because yeah. actually, the thing is that our school is in properly remote area, in village area of Assam. There are some basic internet problems are there. So yeah. they may not be regular in every week or every School Synergy workshop. But mm. whatever I have learned, whatever I have understood, I convey the message to them over okay. telephone or WhatsApp.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah, thanks a lot for doing that. Sir, may I know which which level you are teaching and which school you are in Assam?
Actually, our name of the our school is Nomati Vidyapeeth High Secondary School. And as I have already mentioned to you that I am a vocational teacher. My subject is
vocational
teacher. Yes, yes. My subject is private security, which is come under National Skill Qualification Framework. And I used to teach students from class 9 to class 12 as an elective subject.
Okay. Okay. So thanks for joining us and being so active in our Telegram group also and here also. We will come back to you. Let us hear from other participants also. Deepika Nagarwala, would you like to just speak about what is your motivation behind joining these sessions, how we can make it more meaningful for teachers? Go ahead. Been a regular, right?
Yes, so I have been attending for the past 6 months. Not really been very regular, but I'm the principal of a CBSE senior secondary school, and we are in a place called Ahmednagar, which is in Maharashtra. Since last year was completely virtual and online, we have been able to settle down as far as academics is concerned by using technology to the fullest. My expectations from the school synergy workshops are two points that I'd like to highlight. One is to be able to find ways to do community projects and skill-based projects virtually, ideas on how it can be implemented in the virtual classrooms, because that is something that I think the new education policy also wants us to implement. So if we can have a start from now onwards and get things rolling in the same direction, that would be helpful. The second thing is to be able to bridge the gap between school education and what is expected from students in colleges and universities. I think there's a huge gap between the skills, the kind of skills that are required once you enter into formal education of professional careers. So some kind of a bridging of that gap, more of application-based, or what is it that we want from students? So these are two aspects that really motivate me to join your sessions. And I have actually been able to pick up a lot of pointers which can be implemented, but I'm looking forward to many more. Yeah, so thanks.
Thanks a lot, Deepika, for sharing your ideas. So yes, we will consider what you had said. I think community projects and how to bridge the gap between school education and college education. Yes, I understand these are quite tenuous areas and one needs to work extensively to be able to support teachers at this level. And we have focused at higher secondary to some extent, but not at that level that prepares them for college education. I think overall in our Indian education scenario, very little work has been done to support school students to get to prepare them for college education itself. Because in our society, the whole focus has been on getting into some sort of entrance exam, preparing for board examination. And people have not really thought about what kind of skills need to be developed for students to perform well at college level. In fact, I mean, when I have interacted with the students, what I found is that they find it very difficult to articulate their own ideas because the whole school education has been memorizing from textbooks and writing it down from verbatim from the textbook itself. Some people do not even know how to articulate their ideas or how to write the ideas properly, how to make the flow of the writing itself. And these are the skills, I think, which are very much needed in the higher level. Even the research skills are very much needed. Most people consider research as something which is very similar to just going on the Google and typing that keywords. That's it. That's what they think about it. But it is much more than that. And one needs to really develop. So I'm happy that more people have joined. We will just listen to them and we'll come back for another round of discussion. Thank you, Deepika. Shikha Pallavi, I know you have also been regular. You have joined in several sessions. Good afternoon. Please share your motivation and also let us know in what ways we can make it more meaningful for teachers like you who are attending these sessions.
What I feel, I have been, in touch with this TIS courses right from the day I enrolled in this E06 strategies to teach short stories. So I pursued two courses and looking forward for one more. What is good about these workshops, what you conduct most of the Saturdays, on most of the Saturdays, that they give us ideas how to proceed with our teaching learning process, how to adopt, project-based learning, and some new apps are introduced, and how to tackle with, and those speakers who are, you seems to be quite experienced and learned, they help us to understand the multiple intelligence, keeping everything in mind that how we can, take this multiple intelligence and project-based learning and 21st century skills in our academic process. So what I look forward, what I think that you should include is all those good things, what is required to make a new lesson plan, the new way how to, include resources, links and all. What I say, there are many things which I wanted to say, but since you suddenly told me to speak, I am speechless. So
you can take some time, compose your thoughts, and you can speak again at any point of time during
one
the
thing
session.
Is this lesson plan discussion. One time you can take that today we'll have lesson plan work discussion, and those teachers who are the part of the Synergy group, Telegram group, there are many, I get ideas from there. We share our thoughts on that platform. I know most of them are not active, but yet those who are active, they help us to explore more, right? So in case if you add something like lesson plans, how to make very attractive lesson plan and include project-based learning and something more about 21st century skills, some game-based, some quizzes that how we can proceed with all those things while proceeding with this teaching learning process.
Okay, so you want more sort of hands-on sessions where we directly work on something that can be taken to the classroom and done with the students itself. And there, I think we have had less of those kind of sessions, more of sharing of ideas and resources. Yes, we can think of those kind of sessions also.
Like
it would be very interesting.
Crossword puzzle, and I remember someone was sharing these apps we can include while teaching. So similar kind of thing, if you can think of again.
Mm-hmm. Okay, sure. Yeah. Thanks for sharing your thoughts. We you can at any point of time come back and speak if you remember something else. Yeah. Who would like to go next? Would anyone like to speak next? Jasneet, Mamta, Shubhangi, Ashu, anyone?
May I?
Yeah, sure. Please go ahead.
Sorry, I just joined 5 minutes late. Actually,
should I repeat my question or did you hear that?
Please, if you do that.
Yeah. So the first point that we are discussing is everyone who has joined today is sharing what has motivated them to join these Synergy sessions multiple times and has motivated them to also join the Telegram group. So what is the motivation and how we can make it more meaningful for them to engage in both these online sessions as well as the Telegram group? Yeah, Jasneet.
So I have been, I think, I have attended most of the workshops which have been designed by School Synergy Group, and I really find them really meaningful to implement the ideas in my classroom. Should I first introduce? I just forgot. I'm basically a secondary school teacher and teaching mathematics in government schools. It's a girls' school, basically, where I'm teaching. And I've also done my PhD in education from Jamia. I also a good friend of Ruchi, and I really liked the way she takes mathematics education and how she is actually developing the community of mathematics. So as a teacher, my experience with School Synergy Workshop has been really insightful. Yes, the kind of ideas which I get from School Synergy Workshops are actually meaningful to implement. I remember some of the workshops, I was just thinking like what I am going to speak, and 2-3 workshops just flashed back into my mind. And one of them was Rakhi Banerjee's workshop on algebraic thinking, because I am actually struggling with the algebraic thinking of my students at class 9th and 10th level. They just, scare of the word X. So it's been really tough for me to actually cope up with. And I actually wanted some research-based work to work upon. Last year, I also tried to use design thinking process with my students to get some trajectory on algebra for my class 9 students. But I could not work them fully because of this lockdown. For some time, the schools were open, then I tried to form some of the task which could help them. So one of them was I directly use Rakhi Banerjee's worksheet, and there were some amazing things that were coming out. So I actually would like more to know about the kind of research-based inputs that can be implemented in the classrooms, specifically for algebra. Another very insightful thing about School Synergy Workshops is because being a mathematics person, I was not aware of what kind of pedagogy is being used in other kind of subjects, for example, language and science. So I try to, it really helped me to explore the kind of, I remember that, what do we say, she used a translation as a,
as a mode to engage, yeah, as a pedagogical strategy. Yeah,
that was really good. I really find it, even in the mathematics, it somewhere can helpful, because we can go into the meaning of the word by using this translation tools. This is another very good workshop, which I really find directly to implement in the field. And there was another workshop that was about poetry. And the kind of poems that came out. I mean, I never thought of that poems. But that YouTube link I could not find because this is the time it doesn't actually suit me, because I just came from my school and there's so many hustle and bustle. Sometimes I'm traveling, so I could not completely concentrate.
You can just ask for any of these workshop on the Telegram group itself. If you're not able to find on YouTube, we will share it. We have a repository. In fact, just wanted to share with everyone that we are also developing our website in such a way that you can find the relevant School Synergy workshop recording, and you can even post some comments on that recording, under the recording itself, as to if you find any ideas useful, because that we also want to know what was useful for you. Yeah, go ahead, Jasneet. Continue, please.
Thank you. So, these are some of the examples which I've just taken it, and I just reminded me just out of the blue it came out. And why I am continuing with attending this workshop is what is motivating me. I have already explained, I'm always exploring to implement good ideas at my classroom. So I always try to look for some good things. And what I want, what I expect more from the workshop, I mean, the way you're doing is actually wonderful. It's a combination of everything. You are taking ground experiences as well and research based. But yes, last week, the kind of workshop that has been done, it was actually the implementation experience. I mean, you have taken one school, alternative school, and how the things are being implemented in speaking to practice. So that kind of workshop we can have more. And similarly, okay. we can have some research-based pedagogy or trajectories. Mm-hmm. Specifically, as I told you about algebra is a problem. So yeah. for that kind of difficult concepts, we can have some research-based learning trajectories workshop, then it will be helpful.
Thanks a lot. Yeah, thanks, Justine. Okay. Anybody else? Mamta, Shubhangi, Ashu?
I'll just speak for a while because I'm in the midst of something, but just give me a moment. I would like to congratulate you, number one, for such painstaking efforts and wonderful efforts throughout engaging everyone, especially during the lockdown. I couldn't attend many of the workshops, but whatever workshops I attended, the best part was that it was as if the speaker is talking with me. So it was at the level of each one of us, as if we were able to connect with whatever was being discussed, and it was at every stage an effort was made that it is participative. So whether it was having the teams or whether it was through question answer. So that was the one thing which really made a difference, that one really looks forward to attend those kind of sessions where you are thinking. So every session made, whichever session I attended, I really felt that along with the speaker, I also was thinking. So that was the best part. Secondly, I think whichever session which I attended, I could get those kind of, I could reflect on many of the aspects which I could share with my students as a teacher educator, and I could make them also think on many aspects. For example, being a mathematics teacher educator, the focus always used to be on the mathematical concepts. But once I attended these kind of varied kind of sessions, so it broadens the viewpoint with respect to teaching, with respect to many aspects of the classroom processes. And a little suggestion I would be sometimes for the sessions, if we could have some kind of readings also being shared, simple readings which we can go back to on the session. So whosoever is a speaker, if that speaker can just share one or two simple readings with us, we can go back to, so that we can keep it in our mind. That's the only thing, but I really would like to congratulate to all of you who are involved behind the scene or on the scene for these sessions. You really make us live these sessions. So thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you, Ashu, for sharing your thoughts as a teacher educator. It's really nice to see that we have been able to manage to interest teacher educators as well as teachers on the same platform. And it would be, we are hoping that going forward, we can have much more meaningful interactions between the teacher educators and teachers, because these interactions do happen at the pre-service level when one is a student teacher, but when one becomes a teacher, it becomes really difficult to get back to teacher educators and discuss new ideas with them or share ideas which have worked in the practice. So I hope we will be able to provide more such platforms going forward. Yeah. Okay. Shubhangi, Mamta. Ha, Jasmeet. Go ahead. Wanted to see.
No, I something? Just wanted to add here, because I think this is very important point, what you raised to connect between teacher education institutes and the teachers, because even NEP doesn't talk about it. It has placed school teachers professional development at a separate place and teacher education at a separate place. That's what I found in NEP. So it's very important to link between teacher pre-service and in-service.
Yes, yeah, definitely. I definitely agree with you, Justine. Yeah. Okay. Shubhangi, Mamta, Aditya.
Yes, I would like to say something. Share something.
Yeah, Shubhangi, please go ahead.
Yeah. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can.
I was not very fortunate to attend many sessions. I have just attended maybe two or three live sessions.
Okay.
But I'm going to 2 to 3 recordings of older one. And what I liked about these sessions, they really give you different ideas, how to use that, implement it in the classroom. I might not be the right person to share because I'm not the regular teacher. I'm an academic-based maths educator, where I use different types of hands-on activities or games for my students.
Sorry, I didn't hear you clearly. Maths educator where?
Where I used different types of hands-on activities through games and puzzle solving.
But I'm sorry, I didn't hear you. Where you are working? I didn't get that.
Yeah, I'm working in Pune with LearnQuest for last 10 years. And okay. now I'm collaborating activities with Vichar Vatika.
Okay. That's great. Yeah.
So it is kind of an exploration kind of thing. So what is there were many things I learned from these workshops. What I would like to have something, as someone said, lesson plans would be great idea to discuss, maybe in a group. As reading, someone suggested, there are many videos which we can discuss, whatever we know, I think we can post it on the group. Then games. And one more thing I would like to discuss or get it from the group as such. There are many different types of methodology that we use in the classrooms. Something like maths talk or maybe fair share, notice and wonder. Questions are open for kids and they just come up with different ideas. So something like this, if we can share, or
more pedagogical ideas.
More pedagogical ideas, which can be used across the subject, not specially mathematics, or something else also. That would be a great thing. I mean, we can do as a group. You're doing wonderful job. I mean, I would definitely like to attend each and every session, but let us see.
We would definitely want to have you here regularly.
Thank you, Ruchi.
Thanks a lot.
Very nice experience with you.
Okay. Mamta or Aditya, would you like to speak?
Mamta,
go ahead.
School Synergy program is really growing great. And I would like to appreciate your efforts and congratulate you, ma'am. These School Synergy programs, I have been watching this, maybe almost all the programs I'm watching, and it has helped me to develop insight in my teaching learning process. And I think my views have become more comprehensive in the sense I don't have really an exact examples for this, but one thing I felt is every time I feel I should change something. After every class, I feel I should change something. And whatever the change is, I see some happiness in the face of the children, my students, not children, students.
Yeah.
And when I see something different in my different emotions in my students, and the way they answer is different. And my colleagues have really said, hey, nowadays children, your students are thinking in a different way. And I feel that maybe because of this program, that is one thing, that is a change. And the sessions were facilitated by people who have worked towards the topic with passion. And it's really good. I have enjoyed.
Yeah. Any particular session you liked, ma'am? Sorry.
Implemented in different sessions. These sessions are helping me in some or the other way. That's what I feel. And your moderation, speaking about your moderation, it is really special. Sometimes you compliment the facilitator, sometimes you supplement the facilitator, and sometimes you probe questions. You just ask some questions which make maybe the facilitator and also the participants to think about it. That's really nice.
Okay.
Really doing great. And maybe I'm becoming more sensitive in my process. And I feel that I want much more information regarding the teaching methodology in social sciences.
Okay.
And I did not get anything about social sciences as such.
Yes, that is our weakness. Yeah, I would agree. Social sciences, we have not been able to have many sessions. It's partly my weakness, I would say, because I am from the science background and I know more people from the science background. But it is true that there have been less sessions about the social sciences. We will work towards it. We will work on getting more social sciences topic.
Yeah, a little bit I wanted. I expected something from social sciences on every Saturday, but the topic is a little different. But it's an interdisciplinary approach. And even the other subjects, knowing other subjects, the way to deal with other subjects has really helped me. And even those strategies has helped me to implement something in my subject. It is not that. That can be done only in maths or only in science or only somewhere in other subjects. And those and more of an interdisciplinary approach, maybe I'm able to give explanation or examples from other subjects, and that is enjoyed by my students and my colleagues wherever we just discuss.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, ma'am.
Yeah, thank you, Mamta ma'am. And it is really very interesting to see both Jasneet and Mamta ma'am have said that they have benefited from watching sessions on subject disciplines other than theirs. And they have learned something from that. And this is something which has, I feel, is new. And our academic community is still to work on this and develop this in a more integrated manner. Because interdisciplinary understanding of teachers and how that helps them in improving the pedagogy in their own subject. This is something really new, and I'm really happy that we have been able to do that. In fact, when we started this school synergy sessions, we were thinking that whether we should have different groups of math, science, languages and humanities, and then just for different groups we will have different sessions, and only those teachers will be joining in who are from that discipline itself. But when we started, we just kept that idea aside, and then we just tried to have ideas which all the teachers can join. All the teachers might be facing some issues about it, and also some along with some subject-specific ideas, because this we do believe that the subject-specific ideas need to be developed, to be discussed in more detail, because there might be certain concepts which need to be analyzed further, teased out, what kind of problems students are facing. Those need to be discussed to be able to address the concept. But yes, it is really interesting to see interdisciplinary learning also. Mamta ma'am, go ahead. You wanted to speak.
Actually, when I speak of interdisciplinary approach, I just want to share one thing. Many times what is happening is I forget my subject and other teachers say that, hey, my students are doing good in maths. Okay. That is, and what about my subject? I'm worried. That is my problem right now. Just enjoying that, and sometimes they also, my students also give examples from maths that this, but somewhere I'm lost because in social studies, social sciences, and really knowing it would other be, disciplines.
Yeah, no, it would be really interesting if you can. If you don't mind providing a video of one of your lessons so that we can also see in what interesting ways you bring these ideas from different discipline together. And maybe we can also learn, maybe we can also raise a few questions or points which can help all of us to learn from each other. So till now, we have been only doing sessions which are telling or talking about a certain approach. And I think it would be very interesting if we can also have a video about teacher teaching a student and we all discussing those what is happening in the classroom, the kind of interaction that is there, and learning from that aspect also. So please, if you don't mind, I mean, at some point, if you do share that video with us, maybe we can have a discussion on that.
Sure, ma'am. But right now, we have completed all the syllabus. I'm a teacher educator.
At any point, do you feel you can do that? Not necessarily now, ma'am.
Yeah.
At any point.
Yeah, because...
Yeah.
Maybe next month we have exams. And then once again, when the course begins, I may be able to do that and send you. Certainly, ma'am.
Sure.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Aditya Roy Chaudhary, would you like to speak up? Aditya, will you like to speak up? Okay, I think you have to unmute yourself. If you want to come back later, it's okay. We also have two students here who have been regularly attending the workshops, Chitra Kumari and Deepak Arora. If any of you would like to speak about your experience as a student of education. So we have heard from teachers, we have heard from one teacher educator, one school administrator, Deepika Nagarwala, and let's hear from students now. Chitra Kumari, Deepak Arora, any of you? Would you like?
Yeah.
Go ahead, Deepak. Yeah.
Yeah, hello, everyone. This is Deepak. For us, like being a student at TIS Mumbai, so we actually... this COVID time, a lot of theoretical aspects we learn on the education. So it's always good when during these sessions, we get the practical insights from practitioners. So mapping those theories with practice, it's always a, it complements our learning. So in that way, all the sessions have been quite useful for me, especially. Yeah.
Okay. Any session in particular that you really liked?
There are many, in fact. For every session, we had something new coming up on the plate because there was so much of diversity in the lessons, all the sessions which we had, covering many topics. So even if we take the example of the previous sessions, so we had from Mahatma Gandhi International School, I believe.
MGIS.
So that also, it broadened our thinking, how, those innovative ways can be put into practice, and it is working well. Sometimes when we learn in theories, okay, these are the ways things can be done, but having a practical insight which is in action, this is always, it gives a kind of trust to us, it is doable and it is working well and bringing the results also. So that way, these are the interesting things which always complements our learning and boost our confidence. Okay, tomorrow when we go to the field, then no doubt we should be quite open towards those ideas, and these are quite working well.
Yeah. Thank you, Deepak. Chitra, do you have anything to say?
Yes, ma'am.
Sure.
So in the past couple of months, I was there for almost all the sessions, and even before I had attended some sessions. And yeah, like what Deepak said, it's really whatever we are learning in our as a theory, and when we see practitioners coming, it's really helping us in those ways. So some of the sessions that I really remember and like was a teacher who was talking about the puppet, how to use puppet in the teaching, or the storytelling session. Then we had a session on that artistic kind of learning where we can feel good about teaching and learning. And even the last session was really insightful because it had the experiential learning in it. So, seeing this, I just, feel motivated that when I become a teacher, I can use and implement these things. And also hearing to all the teachers that come here and they share their experiences is really something that I really look up to every week. Yes. And just like something that we can do is like one of our teachers said that if we could get some resources or reading, so whatever PPTs that the speakers are sharing, maybe we can share it with everybody, so we could keep it as a resource. That I think will be helpful.
Yeah,
Yeah, that's all, ma'am. And it's really interesting.
Yeah. Thanks a lot, Chitra and Deepak, for speaking. I'm happy that as students also, you have been able to learn from practitioners, because this is a perspective which is perhaps gets lacking in the pre-service teacher education. And it is good to interact with the practitioner right when you are learning about being a teacher itself. So thanks a lot for sharing. Aditya Rai Chaudhary, I saw that you tried connecting with the other device also. Maybe you had some problem unmuting. Would you like to try now? Or you can post on the chat also. If you are having trouble unmuting, you can post on the chat. It's fine. Okay. So, it was really nice to hear the different suggestions that you have given and what you have really liked. I just want you all to take a moment to recollect. What I'll do is I'll share maybe, or I'll just ask you to think about the sessions that you really liked and post it on the chat itself, if you can, because it would really help. Yeah. So it would really help for us to know which sessions you really liked and to have a record of it so that we can get a sense of what kind of sessions we should plan going forward.
Ma'am, there was one session which was actually based on some puzzles were given. I have a screenshot. I'll have to recall. There was
you don't remember the name of it, is it?
That crossword puzzle. I mean, puzzle maker app was.
I think it was Anusha Ramanathan's session on games which you can use in
yes,
teaching of
yes,
English.
Yes.
English issue. Either Anusha Ramanathan or Surbhi.
Either Anusha ma'am or Surbhi ma'am was there. I remember.
And it was
really helpful. Being an English teacher, I just make them do the work collaboratively to my students to make a puzzle out of the words which are there in their literature book, keeping all the meanings at the bottom and then make the puzzle that I really like. Okay. One more suggestion I would like to give. There are many teachers. Like I myself is one of the most innovative teacher of my school, and I keep on sharing ideas how to proceed with the some apps like Quizlet, like there is one Edu Puzzle, then Ed Puzzle, Quizlet, then there is one whiteboard also we can share, and where we can have a collaborative work with the students. So there are n number of apps I explored, and I keep on doing those things like Lucid Chart for mind mapping and concept map.
Yeah.
Then, so these things, the way I'm sharing now, I want every teacher to share with us, and we can have some kind of talk shows that, you know, learning from each other can make
exactly.
us better.
Thank you so much for sharing this thought, because this is what I was coming to next, that all of us spoke about so many different sessions, but there is a great deal of learning that we can have from learning from each other by sharing the practice itself. And I would like to really include that aspect in our school synergy itself in some way. Right now, what happens is the person will come, there will be a speaker, he will speak about it. Yes, it can be interactive, you can include there, but still it is an ideation level and it is in a different space from the classroom itself. Yes, we have tried to bring the classroom inside this session itself in form of artifacts, in form of plans, in form of what work students have done, what kind of activities have been used, what kind of app has been used. But I want to get it more classroom focused. So it would be nice if we can share videos, if we can share students' work of whatever ideas was discussed in one session. And during the week when we are there on the Telegram itself, we share ideas that we have implemented or we have planned with the students, or something relevant student work which has come to your notice, which is directly connected to that session, so that we can go more deeper into understanding teaching and developing knowledge of teaching itself. Because that is going to be, I feel, really helpful for all of us, whether it is teachers, teacher educators, or the student teachers that we have here. So, I would look forward to your cooperation going forward. If you can engage in these kind of discussions at the Telegram group that we have, or I was thinking that perhaps we can have alternate week, like 1 week we can have the speaker discussing the idea and sharing it with all of us. And next week we can have sessions like these. These are open talk sessions where we try to take that idea forward by making either a lesson plan based on that idea, or by sharing an experience that you have implemented an idea in the classroom, or sharing something of a student work, which we can use to actually build that idea, or sharing an app, which used to implement that idea.
That is what I was saying. If we can have a Google form, if we can create a Google form wherein whosoever is the participant of school synergy teacher group, if they can all fill what subjects they teach, expertise in that subject, and whether they are interested in conducting a session to share their ideas. So one by one, every teacher's session will help each other.
Mm-hmm. So maybe we can, go ahead, please, continue.
Specifically focusing on their way of teaching, their implementation of apps or innovative ideas, like that. Whatever they have, taken the screenshot while teaching and all those things they can share. So one by one, every teacher will have their presentation or sessions. Those who are interested, they can come. Otherwise, it's not compulsory or mandatory to join the same.
Yeah, anyway, it's not compulsory. Yeah, thank you. But I would like to hear other people's thoughts about this idea that Shikha has proposed. Really looking forward to what you think about it. Jasneet, you yourself a teacher.
I was just now thinking these are two different things which has been ideating this time. Like one, what Shikha is saying, basically to share the teacher experience. I mean, what I am doing in my classroom, and I just want to share that with other teachers. And second idea is which you were talking about, that there would be an ideation session, which is in a different space, and we are supposed to try to implement those ideas in our classroom, and then come up with some of our insights, like whether it has worked or not.
Yes.
So both are different, but both are very good ideas which can be implemented. I would like more to go with your idea. Maybe we can try. We can start with first. We can have a session, and then we can try to implement it. It may take 15 days or 20 days. And then we can come up with one session on whosoever has implemented, use those ideas into their classroom. Then we can have a discussion session on it. And then what teacher experience session could be a different kind of session where just like another session, a teacher is also sharing her experience, and then another teachers can also try to implement what they are actually doing in their classroom.
Yeah.
So it will be more or less like what is already happening, but that is maybe more of theoretical. And now what Shikha is saying will be a practical, just like we had last week, mentally multisensory one, which is already being implemented. So I would actually flag on both the ideas. Both are good. We can.
Thank you. Anybody else? We can unmute and speak. Anybody else want to say whether they like this idea or suggest any other idea?
Yes,
Shikha's idea.
Yes, we can definitely implement that. Learning from each other, I like that concept, because everyone is using something new. They are practicing something new in their teaching methodology. So it will be benefited. Everyone will be benefited from each other's experience and their methods. One thing I would like to add, if someone knows about, I don't know whether these workshops were already done, GeoGebra or PolyPad, use of those kind of things, that will be definitely useful for maths teachers, I feel. So
yeah, GeoGebra one I think session was done, but I'm not sure, but we can have definitely more. That GeoGebra is a vast it's a vast resource, and yes, it can be used in so many different ways.
Some workshop like that where learning will have take place, I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah so definitely we will think about it. So one is always in the dilemma of what kind of sessions to plan, because if we have maths focused, English focused, yes, I know only those teachers will be attending more. But if we have a session which is applicable to all the teachers, there are much more teachers who would be interested in attending. So I think I will have to plan in a way that all different kinds of things are addressed. All these different kinds of sessions we have discussed today are done in a more equitable manner, whether it is teacher experience or ideation sessions or sessions specific to the subject or the interdisciplinary topics that we can take up in these sessions itself. Yeah. Okay. So this was really nice. Shalini, you would you like to pose some question to the group?
I think from Dimeshwar Sharma has said something, ma'am, in the chat box. Shall I read for?
Yeah, as a master trainer, I
have also conducted some
community-based programs and online IT. Yeah, so yeah, I think he can also share what kind of work he has done in some of the sessions. So we will plan such sessions going forward. Shalini, please make a note of it. And Shalini will contact you perhaps for having such sessions. Maybe not for 1 hour long. Perhaps it might be difficult. Maybe we can have two teachers in one sessions sharing their ideas and discussing about it. And we can hope that more teachers from our School Synergy Teachers Forum group will participate in it. Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, Mamta says that showcasing students' presentation will not give much insights. Instead, we need to video the process of learning, focusing on learning and how teachers probes the students of different ability to reach the goal of education and their discourse. Yes, definitely. I understand. But, student work, what I wanted to say here is when you see student work, it helps you to think about how students are thinking. And if you have to be a very responsive teacher and directly addressing the diversity of students in your classroom, then it is important for you to be able to understand student thinking behind the student work. And that's why it really needs to be discussed. And Jasneeta has also said that she has also learned from students. Maybe we'll just try it and see if you can get an idea of whether it is helpful or not, and we can go forward. And now our community has, I think, become quite big. Perhaps we will, even if whatever interaction we have, however participation we have in certain experimental sessions, I think it would be worthwhile for us to explore. And we would be trying something new. So I just hope that your cooperation would be there when we try this. And you also will be participating in that. Yeah. Anything else, Shalini, you want to say?
I think, ma'am, it was really a nice interaction with all of us. This platform, especially School Synergy platform, is so inclusive. Right, we have students, we have teacher educators, teachers, and such platform is rare. And even for me as a student, it's really a great learning platform. And thank you so much all the participants for sharing all the observations you have made during the School Synergy workshop. It is very important for us to go ahead, for the continuous engagement. It is important to have talk session like this. And therefore, we had such talk session today. And definitely in near future, we will be considering the different questions and the different kind of suggestion made by each one of us. We will work on it. And whatever the requirements or the support we all need, we will definitely try to work and see how we can provide support to each one of us. So I think it was really nice, the kind of the different notes which each one of us has made, especially the peer learning. And we would definitely work on those ideas and the interdisciplinary approach and many other, the pedagogy, the lesson planning. These are some of the whole idea, the big ideas which I have noted down. But yes, there are many other suggestions in lineup. We would definitely keep in update through Telegram. And if you come across any other suggestion, you can definitely post in Telegram. We also keep update whatever the kind of activities which are happening in Telegram. And thank you so much for taking this much effort, you know, to welcome others teachers also to join Telegram. That is also a great effort which you people are making, keep doing. And thank you so much for all your participation.
I also want to just thank you once again for taking time out and joining us here and discussing your ideas. Just one last time, I want to ask Aditya Roy Chaudhary if they managed to unmute themselves and speak. Because I think he tried but was not able to. It's okay, you can just share your ideas in the Telegram chat itself. It would be nice to hear from you. So we will try to announce the session by Tuesday, the next session next Saturday. And let's see, we will, myself and Shalini, we will work on the different ideas that we have discussed here and we'll try to implement it going forward. We continuously would be seeking your feedback and your suggestions. Please do keep posting it on the Telegram group. Hesitate to start your own thread, start your own questions in the Telegram group. You are very much welcome to do that. It is your group also. Consider it as your group and just post ideas and points that you want to discuss there. It would be really nice to have from all of you. Okay, so with this, we end this session. We will meet again next week at the same time, 3 p.m., for yet another Synergy session. Thank you all.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Bye, ma'am.